Hello everyone. Welcome to Yashoda Hospital's yet another show, Health Talk Session. Hernia surgery is one of the most common surgeries performed in India. Ever wondered why hernia is most common among Indians? Is it genetic predisposition or something else? So let's discuss about this growing problem today. I'm Dr. Lakshmi, and today we have with us Dr. T. Surendra Reddy, Consultant General Laparoscopic and Robotic Surgeon from Yashoda Hospital's Malakpet. Welcome, sir. So, doctor, with 20 years of experience in this field, so tell us more about this journey.
I've joined this organization in 2001 as a junior consultant. And I'm a consultant laparoscopic and general and laparoscopic surgeon for almost 7-8 years. Then I got into robotic surgery. Since almost 10 years I am doing robotic surgery, and my passion in robotic surgery is hernia. So I am taking hernia as single theme, and I am doing only robotic hernia surgery. And I want to, you know, create my mark in particularly in robotic hernia surgery. I got my robotic training in US. Then subsequently I got certified, and now I am practicing robotic surgeon also.
So doctor, a recent research done by Indian doctors and from their own clinical experience, it seemed to suggest that Indians are more prone to hernias. Is it true, and if so, why?
Basically, the incidence of hernia in males is directly related to their lifestyle, you know, the work what they do. People who are involved with heavy weight lifting and also people who smoke are more prone, because they have the collagen network malformation. So these people are prone for development of hernia. And particularly in female group of patients, what we see is most of the patients who come with already a surgery done, and they come with another swelling in the old operative scar, that we call it as incisional hernia. So these are very common in our Indian population.
So sir, being a surgeon, I'm sure you spend most of your time in the day in the hospital. So how do you balance your personal life and your professional life?
Yeah, definitely the it's going to be very busy, but we do balance, you know, and because of this medical work, the work in the hospital is quite involved with lot of stress. So some stress relieving, you know, I practice yoga in the morning. I do some pranayama and some physical, you know, workout also I do. Otherwise, the wear and tear in the stress in the medical work will definitely we are going to have a lot of stress related diseases.
True, I think a healthy and a fit lifestyle keeps a lot of disorders away. So, talking about lifestyle and fitness, do you think stress and physical activity would also contribute to the occurrence of hernias?
Stress is definitely a important factor occurrence of hernias. That's what one should spend some time for their own body, you know, body and soul, meditation for the soul and body. We have to do some physical work.
So sir, back then when you were getting trained in this field of surgery, I'm sure that time about there was not much information about this robotic surgeries and techniques and all. So how did you develop this interest?
In 2015 I had been to US, where I got trained in Advocate Sherman Hospital in Chicago. Since then, because they are doing a lot of robotic work, because there the medical system, the insurance people, insurance the robotics is they recognize robotic surgery. The real essence of robotic surgery is a precision of dissection and precision of, you know, the suturing is very easy.
So your love for suturing has brought you so far in this field. That's great. So do you always wanted to become a surgeon, or was there any other field which had your interest?
In my childhood, in my family, there was a surgeon, you know, who used to be very, you know, energetic. As a child, I saw him. Then, and the amount of respect he used to get in the society, I thought this is the field I should enter. And then, subsequently, as I joined the medical field, MBBS, and then in that, I saw my seniors who have done their, who have entered into the surgical field. And compared to the medical field, I thought it is a dynamic field. I thought I'll do a general surgery, and I entered. And then subsequently, I'm just going on, you know, adding the newer technologies and newer techniques into my field.
That's great. So we now know that hernia is one of the most common disorders, especially among the Indian population, and many people are being diagnosed with different types of hernia. But at the same time, most of the people are just putting it away because they do not want to take time off from their jobs or work, and they don't want to be burdened by the post-op recovery for weeks. So how robotic surgery is helping with this?
Any patient, when he hears that he should undergo a surgery, first thing comes to his mind is pain. So definitely the pain factor in robotic surgery compared to minimal invasive surgery and conventional surgery is less. Pain is quite less, and the recovery is also a bit faster than the conventional laparoscopic surgery, because we cannot compare robotics with open surgery. We have to compare robotics with laparoscopic surgery. So I think down the line, as the time passes, I think even robotic surgery equipment, the technology also will become cheaper, and that can be, you know, brought to the even common man. Now, as it is expensive, common man may not afford as of now.
So that means robotic surgery results in lesser pain, shorter stay in the hospital, and faster recovery. But I'm sure you must be having a set of patients who would still prefer the old school technique. So how do you convince these patients to undergo this surgeries with the recent techniques?
వాళ్ళకు ప్రతిదీ చెప్పి ఇది ఓపెన్ సర్జరీ అంటే ఇలా ఉంటుంది, ఇంత ఖర్చు అవుతుంది, లాప్రోస్కోపిక్ సర్జరీ ఇది, ఈ మెష్ పెడతాము, ఇంత ఖర్చు అవుతుంది. సో సార్, దీనికి తేడా ఏంటి సార్? నాకు ఎవరో మా ఫ్యామిలీ డాక్టర్ గారు చెప్పారు లాప్రోస్కోపీ వద్దు, రోబోటిక్ వద్దు, ఓపెన్ చేయించుకోమని. అవునమ్మా, సరే, మీకు నేను ఈ మూడు చెప్తున్నాను, మీరు ఏది చేయమంటే అది చేస్తాను. కానీ దీని అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఇది అంటే ఆల్మోస్ట్ 50% ఆఫ్ ద పీపుల్ దే గెట్ కన్విన్స్డ్ ఫర్ మినిమల్ ఇన్వేసివ్ సర్జరీ. అంటే దాని అడ్వాంటేజెస్, దాని ఏదైతే ఫాస్ట్ రికవరీ అనండి, లేసర్ స్టే అండ్ లెస్ పెయిన్, ఈ ఏదైతే దీని అడ్వాంటేజెస్ ఉన్నాయో వాటికి ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేశాక వాళ్ళు 50% ఆఫ్ ద పేషెంట్ దే చేంజ్. ఈవెన్ ద పీపుల్ వర్ నాట్ ఎడ్యుకేటెడ్ ఆల్సో దే నో రిగార్డింగ్ ద మినిమల్ ఇన్వేసివ్, దట్ ఈస్ లాప్రోస్కోపిక్ సర్జరీ. రోబోటిక్స్, ఎస్, పీపుల్ హు ఆర్ ఎడ్యుకేటెడ్, హు ఆర్ యునో ద పర్టికులర్లీ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ పీపుల్ హు ఆర్ ఇన్ రెగ్యులర్ టచ్ విత్ ద ఇంటర్నెట్, సో దోస్ పీపుల్ దే హ్యావ్ ద నాలెడ్జ్ అబౌట్ ద రోబోటిక్స్, దే దెమ్సెల్స్ ask. And I myself, I get lot of patients, a good number of patients from abroad, who, because abroad the robotic surgery is quite expensive. What I feel personally is it is our duty to explain the various modalities, and it is their call, they have to take, you know, decide.
సర్జరీ మీరు చేస్తారా లేదా రోబో చేస్తుందా, ఈ క్వశ్చన్ మీరు ఎలా రెస్పాండ్ అవుతారు?
యా, దిస్ ఈస్ ద కామనెస్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ విచ్ పీపుల్ ఆస్క్. యు నో, దే థింక్ దట్ ద రజని ఇన్ రోబో, లైక్ సచ్ రోబో విల్ బి దేర్, యు నో, పీపుల్ థింక్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ నాట్ ఆపరేటింగ్, దట్ రోబో విల్ హ్యూమనాయిడ్ రోబో దే ఇమాజిన్, అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ద కేస్. I think the technology, the robo which is available in the market as of now, which is FDA approved, is Da Vinci robo. It is basically a master slave system, where the master is the operating surgeon and the robot is a slave. Whatever command I give and whatever command I do in the console, it will be mimicked by the robotic hands which are docked into the patient. So the surgeon should be well versed with the technology and should be trained and certified by the Intuitive Surgicals, then only one can venture into robotic surgery.
So doctor, before concluding this episode, what message you would like to give to the patients out there who are considering a surgery for hernia or postponing their surgeries as far as hernia is concerned?
Basically surgery means, you know, they, because of the fear of anesthesia and pain, they just go on postponing surgery, particularly hernia surgery, but they come back with, you know, complications. So I would like to suggest to my patient population is, you have a hernia, any swelling, to go to a qualified doctor, take the suggestion. If the doctor suggests surgery, there are many techniques available, and many surgeons are doing hernia with perfection. So I think you should go and take opinion and go ahead with the surgery. Please do not postpone. So when it's not complicated, only when it is diagnosed, please do get surgery done, either open surgery or laparoscopic or robotics, that is left to you. But take the advice of a specialist and get the surgery done as early as possible.
So absolutely, I think that is rightly said. So thanks to the innovations in robotic surgery, now the patients can undergo this surgery with less pain, shorter stay in the hospital and recover faster. So this brings us to the end of this session. Thank you all for joining us. Take care and stay safe.